Hello, I'm Fast Lawyer. Today we're going to do a Let's Play and full live review for Visionarium 2, The Descent, a game released on the Steam Store today, June 20th, 2022. It officially supports the HTC Vive, Valve Index, and the Oculus Rift. It normally retails for $15. It's on a release sale, 15% off, and I bought it at that sale price. I'm testing it out on the Meta Quest 2 using Link Cable. And you can use your controls to change the experience. Right now I'm in linear mode, which means the game has, I say game, the experience has a beginning and an end. You can also listen to your own music or have microphone input or have a free fly mode, but this is like the default experience, so that's what you're seeing. And we're about the third of the way into the experience. I fast forwarded, so there are settings in this bit, in this game experience. I keep trying to say game in this experience. in case you're not wondering, Visionarium 2 is very much like Visionarium 1. This is an artistic experience. It's almost like a music video in VR. And this is just an experience where you sit back, enjoy the audio visual, the music visualizer. You can use your own music as well, but again, I'm using the default experience. So this is the default music. This is the default intended linear experience. But there is replayability, as you can choose your own music, you can choose microphone input. There are controls here. As you see, I'm activating some lights by pressing trigger. You do have snap rotation, so you can play comfortably seated and be able to look all around as well. This experience is about 38 minutes long, a little less than 40 minutes. And the experience is very trippy from start to finish. This is just one snippet of the experience. I didn't want to record from beginning to end the whole 38-minute experience because I didn't want to spoil the experience for those considering buying this. So this is just a snippet, something to let you know what you might expect from this experience. But there's like three parts to this experience, and those three parts are different from each other. But they're all like this. In other words, they all have, you know, default music. And I really like to drop here. This is why. I really liked how they did the drop with the indigenous music. And another reason I want to show this is because although I really like the experience, this experience was created in Tilt Brush, and these Tilt Brush artists are just exceptionally talented. But there are some weaknesses in this experience, and my main criticism is that not all the animations are as smooth. Like that guy over there is doing the Charleston dance. It just doesn't fit the music at all. Like, this is a very high BPM song. Some of these dance animations fit the music, but this guy is doing the Shake It Baby, Shake It On Baby dance. You know, doesn't really fit the music, the beat of the music. So needs to be a little bit more fast-paced movements to catch up. Like that girl over there, she's got it going on with the music. But yeah, this Charleston dance doesn't fit the music in any way. Doesn't fit the BPM, doesn't fit what's going on with the music. And again, I can control with my triggers the blinking lights that you can see there. I really like this song. Obviously, this is a experience that's not for everyone. It's not really a game. And I know I kept saying game accidentally, but it's not a game. It's an artistic experience. It's like a long music video. I think if you like the first Visionarium, then you'll like this. I actually think this is better than the first Visionarium. I think it's more creative, more artistic. But they're very similar experiences. You know, they're both like really long music videos, music visualizers. And like I said, you can use your own music. You can use microphone input. You can paint like this or with smaller brushes like this. So you can really change the experience to how you're feeling, but I'm trying to maintain the default experience. And like I said, I don't want to spoil the whole experience, so I'm not going to make this a long review. And like I said, the whole experience is about 40 minutes long, 38 minutes long approximately. And I really enjoyed this experience a lot. I will say my same criticism as the first Visionarium. It is a little pricey for what you're getting, obviously. You know, $15 normal price for a less than 40-minute experience is a hard sell in VR for a lot of people. But all I can say is that I enjoyed the experience. You know, I bought it on sale with my own money, and I don't regret my purchase decision. This is a unique experience in VR, one that I do recommend. And for those of you who enjoy these type of experience, I think it is well worth the money. And like I said before, I'm not an art critic. I don't have the training to be an art critic. You know, I did not study art history. I mean, I think I took a course in high school very long ago, but I know some art history, but definitely not enough. And I'm definitely not qualified at all to be an art critic. So I'm not going to rate this. But I will say that I do recommend it. And that I enjoyed it a lot. And that there's different things to give it longevity. Like I said, there's a free flight mode where you can just fly where you want and see stuff as you want. Like right now, we're kind of like in a guided experience, you know, kind of like on rails experience. This is a default experience, but you can use free flight mode and you can see what you want when you want. You can also choose your own music. And I will say that, you know, this is a very trippy experience. You can tell that the artist here made the most out of Tilt Brush, you know. Very talented. I enjoyed the experience. Definitely don't regret paying artists, because you know, at the end of the day, the money you're choosing is going to, you know, pay for the artist. And these are true artists in a VR medium. I think this is the future of art, and we're kind of early to that here in VR. But yeah, I mean, 3D, fully realized art worlds, basically, music videos. And yeah, like I said, I had a good time. I recommend it. Anyways, I'm Fast Lawyer. This has been my full live review for Visionarium 2, The Descent. If you enjoyed my video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And please subscribe, because I'm sure I'm going to get a copyright strike from this video. It's inevitable. And so you might see some ads on it, but just keep in mind, I'm not monetized, so I don't get any money at all. So anyways, I appreciate all your support. And if you enjoy this type of experience, please support these artists as well. I'm Fast Lawyer. Thanks for watching my video. Hope you have a nice day. Goodbye.